Hello, this is Mark from Excel Off the Grid. In this video, we're going to look at how we can change Power Query's source data based on cell values. If you want to work along with this video, you'll find links and instructions of how to download the example file in the description box below. So if you're ready, let's get started. Before we go any further, I recommend you subscribe and get notifications so that you don't miss any future videos. If you're like me, you build Power Query solutions in a test environment first. Then, when it's ready, you finally release it into the wild. This means the paths of all the source files must be updated. Or maybe you're a consultant who creates solutions for others. When you distribute the workbook to your client, you have to provide them with complicated instructions on how to update the source data in Power Query to work with their environment. Wouldn't it be better if the source could be linked to a cell value, so that we or a client could easily update it? Yes, it would. So in this post, we're going to look at how we do that, how to change the Power Query source based on a cell value. So here's our scenario. We have a source file that's already been loaded into Power Query. And as you can see in the formula bar, that file path has been hard-coded. And as we look down the list of transformations, we get to our final data, which has then been loaded into Excel in cell B6. And all the cells highlighted there. Now I'm not going to show you how to load this data into Power Query because I'm assuming that you already know how to do that. Also in our source file, we have a file name and a file path. Cell C2 contains the file name and cell C3 contains the folder path. These are not currently linked to anything in Power Query. They are presently just text that has been entered into a cell. But by the end of this post, these cells will be connected into Power Query. As we work through this example, remember that these are file locations on my PC, so won't necessarily work for you. You'll need to change the file name and the folder path to the locations that will work on your PC. There are several ways to achieve this end result, and we're just going to look at one of those methods. We're going to start by creating two named ranges. First of all, the named range for the file name. So I'll click on cell C2, and then in the name box, I'll enter file name, and then press enter. I'll repeat the action again for the value in cell 3, only this time I'll call it file path, and press enter again. We'll be combining these two named ranges in Power Query's M code, so make sure that when combined, these two are a valid file path. A common error is to leave out the final slash at the end of the file path, but this is needed to create a valid reference. Okay, we now just need to use our named ranges within our query. So click data, and then queries and connections. If the queries and connections pane isn't visible, then we'll double click on our query to open the Power Query editor. Now, as I said, this method does involve changing the M code, which might seem a bit daunting, but don't worry, this is a simple process and a very short piece of code. So let's go into the advanced editor by clicking view and then advanced editor. And here we can see the M code that drives all of our transformations. In the source step, you can see the hard-coded file path to the current source information. Okay, let's add our named ranges into here. So after the let, we'll create a new line. We'll type file path equals excel.currentworkbook. Open bracket, close bracket. Curly bracket, square bracket. Name equals file path in double quotes. Close square bracket, close curly bracket. Okay, we'll move to the end of that. And in square brackets, we'll type content. Curly bracket, and in that file path content, we want the first record. Power Query starts counting from 0, so the first record is actually 0. And because it's a named range, it doesn't have any headers, which means that Power Query would apply the default headers, which is therefore just called column 1. Make sure we end that with a comma, and then we're going to copy that line, create a new line, and then paste again. As file path already exists, we're going to call this file name, and also reference file name in here. Okay, so now we can remove our hard-coded source file and we can now enter in our named ranges. So it'll be file path and file name, which are the steps that we created above. Good, at the bottom it says we have no syntax errors detected, so we can click Done to exit the advanced editor, and then click Home, Close and Load. Assuming we've done everything correctly, the data in the query is now linked to the cells. So if we change the values in cells C2 and C3, and then click Refresh, it means the data will then be loaded from a new location. Okay, so let's try this out. And I've got a file saved on my PC in the same place that's called another source file. We've updated that and then I'll click refresh all. If we watch that data table, there we go, it updates automatically. So this is a great way to make our Excel workbooks easy to update. We can now point Power Query to the source information that we want to use. And that's it. We've learned how to change the Power Query source based on a cell value. All it takes is a few named ranges and a few short lines of M code. Now any user can easily change the cell to repoint the query to the correct source location. They don't even need to open Power Query or understand how it works. Well, that's it from me. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment, and I'll catch you next time.